Nigerians usually say that the broom used in beating the first, second, and third wives will also be used to beat the fourth wife. But no one ever mentioned that she would cry the loudest, coming less than 7 months after their marriage collapsed scandalously in September 2020. Femi Fani Kayode and his estranged wife, Precious Chikwendu, have now begun a child custody war and they are fighting dirty. While the former Minister of Aviation recruited the help of his ex-wife, Regina, the ex-beauty queen stooped even lower by recruiting his former worker's help. She declared that she will go any length to gain custody of her four sons produced in their 6 years of marriage. She has now promised to unleash hell on the ex-aviation minister and, if possible, beat his stumbling block to his 2023 presidential ambition until he releases her children to her. And it's beginning to look like she's getting there. On March 18, about 7 former workers of Femi Fani Kayode marched down to Abuja's Punch office and recounted how violent and unstable he is. While a woman among them accused him of sexually harassing his female staff, others confirmed that he is in the habit of assaulting his workers. This comes after his ex-wife, Snow White, cited domestic violence as the reason for leaving the marriage, and these testimonies from his workers, including the viral video of him berating a journalist last year, are enough proof. Who will win this war? Will the testimonies from his workers help Precious get her children back? And will the testimonies ruin the already infamous Fani Kayode 2023 presidential ambition? Hello guys, it's T-Code here for African Gleeds. It's no secret that the marriage between popular politician Femi Fani Kayode and ex-beauty queen Precious Chikwendu came to a bitter end in September of 2020. Like you all know already, it was the former aviation minister's fourth marriage. They got married in 2015 and were married for 6 solid years. They are parents to 4 sons, including a set of 2-year-old triplets. Their marriage breakup certainly came as a rude shock to Nigerians because they were fond of displaying affection on social media. But following their separation, Precious opened up that it was a marriage filled with pain and violence. She confirmed that her public display of affection made Femi Fani Kayode look like a good husband if word ever got out about his violent nature. While some of her family members continued to insist their marriage broke down due to a health challenge, bipolar disorder, which she manages, Precious insists that it is due to domestic violence meted on her by the politician, including when she was pregnant. She said he called the triplet in her womb cockroaches while punching her stomach. Describing him as a narcissist, Precious said Fani Kayode is a violent and unstable man who assaults her every time. She said he locks her up in the house, starves her, and sometimes bars her from seeing her children. While she had always wanted to leave the marriage, she said she only stayed because Fani Kayode threatened to take her children from her. She finally summoned the courage to run away in 2020, except her children are still with him, and he has refused to let her see them after she ran for her life. Months after, Precious has declared war on her ex-husband and now fighting for full custody of her 4 children. Taking the matter to an Abuja court, Precious is now demanding custody of her 4 sons and asking the court to compel the former aviation minister to give her a monthly payment of 3.5 million naira for the children's upkeep. On March 5, 2021, which was the first day of the court proceeding, she posted a photo of herself with 4 security men. In the caption, she said she would continue to fight for custody of her children regardless of the threats and intimidation from her ex-husband. She said that even though he mocked her for having nobody to fight with her, she has God. She then added that he calls her Kalesi because he knows that behind a pretty face is a warrior. When a follower asked her why she's choosing battle instead of peace, she responded by saying, until she carries a precious first in her, having multiple births that almost led to her death, has her thyroid taken out and her children taken away from her, she doesn't have an answer to give. Through his media aide, Femi Fani Kayode fired back on March 6, 2021 and called her a pathological liar, adulteress and slanderer while promising to prove it in court. He said she is unfit to be a mother and has shown nothing but cruelty to the 4 boys she has never taken care of. Fani Kayode also noted that granting her custody of the kids would endanger them, whereas he is the better parent and has provided 12 nannies for them. Making matters worse, he recruited the help of his first wife, Regina, who claims to be legally still married to Femi Fani Kayode last year. In a statement sent to the press, she called Precious' court affidavit defamatory, scandalous, and false. Further calling her a strange woman, she accused Precious of being a wretched ingrate. The former aviation minister's first wife went ahead to call Precious a sick woman who was in a mental facility for a month and admitted to cheating. She alleged that Precious collected $500,000 from Fani Kayode within a few months of meeting him for a fake investment. She further stated that Fani Kayode set up four businesses for her, which she squandered and sponsored her sister's wedding, adding that six of her relatives lived in the ex-minister's house for 6 years and depended on him for food, upkeep, medical bill, and school fees. While many Nigerians debated if it was all Loriro and if Femi Fani Kayode is the one posing as his first wife, Precious fired back. Apparently, the ex-minister bit more than he can chew, and Precious decided to fight dirty by defaming his character. It is believed she recruited his former workers to do the job. On March 18, 2021, one after the other, about seven of the ex-minister domestic workers marched down to the Punch office in Abuja to recount his violent nature. A former cook described the ex-minister as a paranoid soul that gets angry for no reason. He said, "There was time he had a knife and was walking around the table and said, 'I will kill you now. I will send you to hell now.'" Another worker said that he's a violent man who was in the habit of using bodyguards to assault them and give them corporal punishment, adding that he was also found of deducting from their salaries. Another former cook said he once stripped him naked, beat him up, and tore his clothes because he wasn't satisfied with his cooking. A former driver said he once watched Fani Kayode order the arrest of a barber for overcharging him, and a former nanny accused him of sexually harassing female staff. She said, "He threatens to beat me up whenever I protest his harassment." Coming on the same day, Precious took to her Instagram page to post adorable videos of her and her kids and added the caption, "It's okay for them to say I'm crazy for not letting them break me, but the love you and I share, they would never know. Till you're back in my arms, I won't stop exposing their lies." From all indications, Femi Fani Kayode has the most to lose in this war, as he is not only a politician but nursing a presidential ambition for the 2023 election. While he has continued to allege that his ex-wife is sick and suffering from bipolar disorder, she has exposed him as a violent man. Recall that since the ex-minister berated a journalist in a video that went viral last year, he became less popular among Nigerians. And now that his ex-workers have come out with these shocking revelations, it could hamper his presidential ambition. On the other hand, Precious is now gaining public sympathy. Many celebrities, including Juliet Ibrahim, Victoria Inyama, the lady golfer, blogger Stella Demokokos, and others are solidly supporting her and actively campaigning for her with the hashtag Justice for Precious. For this reason, it looks like Precious is winning, but the certainty of all this lies in the hands of an incorruptible judge. Was Fani Kayode right for keeping his fourth wife's children away from her? Do you believe the ex-minister or his former wife? And lastly, do you think the ex-minister's former workers' testimonies will affect his 2023 presidential ambition? Please share your opinion with us in the comment section down below. If you found this video informative, please give it a like and share. Don't forget to check out our channel for more interesting African stories and news we know you like. Subscribe to get notifications whenever we drop a new juicy video to keep you updated. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and see you again soon.